Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
What a game we have in store for you today as two rivals are about to go at it for state bragging rights. Oklahoma State will be kicking off, and you can just feel the energy in the air for this opening kickoff. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 33-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Tailback, and he dropped it.
Whoever was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 33-yard line. Second down. Tackle made right around the 30.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Stop at the 41-yard line. Well, they get all those yards, but come up just shy of the first.
Good play call, almost perfect execution, except for the fact that they're not going to get the first down.
Jackson is back to receive. He drops it. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
That's a tough break. Whether you lose the ball or not, it can mess with your head when that happens.
That return man is lucky that his team got the ball back, or he would have heard an earful from the coach. Actually, he probably will anyway. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. They go with the run. And he's tackled at the 33.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Lateral's back. Nice gain as he works the right side.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up third and 2.
Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. And now he's got room to run. They'll bring him down at about the 45. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
Runs it left for a decent gain.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That makes it second and two.
Runs right for a nice gain.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. First down.
Double tight, double tight. Four down.
Hey, it's coming.
Easy. Rally.
Motion.
He's taken down around the 35-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Just throws this one away. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. The Cowboys lost one of their key guys earlier to that injury, and unfortunately, I don't think he's going to play any more football today. Zips it to the back, and down he goes, around the 26-yard line. Comes through. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency.
Looking for his man, incomplete. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
That makes it 7-10.
From their own 26-yard line. Second down. Tackle at the 45-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Picked. That could have been a big play for the defense.
Yeah, even though he had a good shot at picking it off, it's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
From their own 45-yard line, it's second down. Fires incomplete.
Number 86, the intended receiver on the way. That brings up third and 10.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Fires quick. He's got another one. And he's taken down at the 49. The Cowboys quarterback went down with that injury earlier. He's still in the locker room, and the word we're getting, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to play anymore today. Tulsa's got a new coach at the helm here in this one, Herbie, and you got to wonder what kind of impact that's going to have. Players will always want to sell out for a new coach, so I expect an emotional game and a lot of big plays.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing.
They'll knock him down for a loss. They'll lose a yard on that quarterback keeper. We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 22-yard line. Gives it to the back. And they'll get him in the backfield.
I think sometimes offenses forget to even include corners as defenders and tacklers because a lot of corners just want to be out there and playing against the pass. But this is a corner that they have got to be responsible and remember in the future that he's got to be involved in being able to come up with a blocking scheme. This time they just let him go, and he's athletic and strong enough to come up and make a play.
So that'll make it fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on the pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Holly is the punter. Looking for the corner. Rawls takes it to the 45, brought down at the 46. Got to give some applause to the defense. They really came out playing strong today.
Well, you know better than me, Brad. This college football game is about emotion. And to be able to play great defense in a college game, you've got to come out and play with your hair on fire. We've seen that from both of these defenses so far.
So at the end of one, still no score. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Throws it out and it falls incomplete.
That pass didn't look exactly right when it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball and it comes out a little wobbly.
From the 46-yard line, it's second down. Grabs it and hammered right there. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Got a man in and out of his hands. And they'll take over on downs. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He's under pressure. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Tackled around the 47-yard line. Gets to around the 42, and that'll give him another first down.
Excellent job there, Brad, of running the football. That was good execution by this offense.
Down at the 29.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Roger, Roger! 51, Mike! Mike 51! It's just me and you! It's just pass! Run, 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 run!
Hand off, and he's met in the backfield.
If this offense keeps running at this guy, they're going to have to rethink some of their play calls.
We've got a second and 14, all in the 33. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Fires out quickly to the tailback. Tackle made at the 18-yard line.
That's a D of 12 on the play. First down.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Mike 51, Mike 51. Set, Oklahoma, Oklahoma.
Runs it and tackled in the backfield. From the 22-yard line, second down.
is 3rd and 15.
51, Mike! Mike 51!
Set, check!
Check nine, check nine!
Steps up in the pocket and sacked.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
After the sack, it's now 4th and long.
Down, huge play.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So an 11 play, 63-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. Oklahoma State gets set to kick this one away. He'll take it from the 2. And he just got stood up right there. And the defense made a big stop on 4th down the last time this offense was out there.
Nothing can impact an offense more negatively than being stopped on a series of downs. And that's what happened to this offense the last time they were out. It's not just the quarterback's job to try to get this offense going. I think it starts up front. A veteran offensive line. See what kind of leadership they have to try to change this thing around.
From their own 24-yard line. Second down. And they make the stop at the 35. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled around the 49-yard line. That one's more than good enough for the first down.
Well, Brad, that is a great play by the quarterback to find his target past the marker to keep this drive moving.
It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Rifles it right. And he hits him hard at the 29-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Quick throw out to the receiver.
And that sets them up for the 1st and goal.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a 1st down.
Bring him down at the 7.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That brings him 2nd and goal.
Throws it and it's caught for the touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. Tulsa ready to kick this one off. Jackson from the 4. And he's taken down at the 25.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
Makes the grab
and he's got the first. He's taken down around the 45-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
From their own 45-yard line, first down. And he is drilled at the 35-yard line. Oklahoma State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. To the halfback on the screen, and they push him out right around the 42-yard line.
That'll make it third and 13.
So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. He wants it all. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 10. We've played a half. We're even at 7 in this one.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find, Reese, these ball hawks on defense. They need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Well, Reese and David, I know you're jealous. This is the kind of games you guys like to do. But that's Thursday night. This is the big show.
He's to the 20.
He's tackled at the 33-yard line. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. And he tackles him hard at the 48.
Gain of 15 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Right. Four down. Mike 51.
Slings it. That's a great tackle. The 48-yard line.
It's a loss of 4 yards.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Holly to punt. Didn't get all of that one. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping.
makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Wants to go long and done. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Number 86, the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and
from their own 38-yard line. Third down. The sub package in there defensively in this five-wide receiver set. He guns it to the left. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Casey was the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
And he can't hang on to the ball.
That's a tough play. Whether you lose the ball or not, it can mess with your head when that happens.
Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Down he goes, around the 39-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
Two times. Go down. Mike 51.
Got some open field. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a gain of seven on the play. First down.
The defense wasn't fooled at all on the option, and it was their discipline that created that turnover.
Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Quick strike, and he drops it. From the 49-yard line, it's second down. Throws complete. He's hammered.
Gain 5 yards. That'll make it 35.
Mike 56. Double.
A junior makes the catch. Tackle at about the 29-yard line.
By the defense of getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. And he's taken down around the 15-yard line. It to the 15-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Roger. Check.
Just throws this one away. So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down.
When you
feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Tulsa could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up, and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 25-yard line.
Tulsa's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
There he goes. He makes his way out to about the 35.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
Run, and he's brought down.
That's a gain of six on the play. That makes it first and ten.
Here we go, here we go. Tight right. Four down.
He's tackled at the 39.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
From their own 39-yard line. Second down. He's at midfield. Makes it out to about the 40. Down at the 43-yard line.
You've got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. And folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. Tulsa's got a 3-point lead. We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
Mike 51. Set. Watch 10-19. Motion.
Halfback's got it on a quick throw. Tackle made at the 39-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 along the way. Third down.
Man left.
He guns it right side. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. He's hit and taken down.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball.
Tulsa is up by 3. He makes his way to about the 45. Got it out to his tight end. And they make the stop at the 49.
That makes it 7-6.
Right.
to around the 42. Complete and taken down immediately.
That makes it second and six.
Makes it out to about the 29. From the 29-yard line, it's second down. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. Here's the eighth play of the series. Tulsa is up a field goal. Throws a strike over the middle, and he's tackled at about the 13.
Good job here by the receiver. Look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass. Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions, and especially when the defense starts to get pressure. You've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
They'll bring him down right around the 12-yard line. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's taken down at the 8-yard line.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up fourth and five.
So it's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. Jackson from the six, and he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. The Cowboys have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him, or do they do something different?
I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
First down.
From their own 39-yard line, first down. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Got a man complete, and he's hit hard.
Russell makes the tackle at the 45-yard line.
Man, left, man, left.
brings up second and five.
They go back to him on a quick throw. And down he goes around the 42-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. From the 42-yard line, second down. Got a man. Watch out here. He gets hit out of bounds at the 28.
Call it a gain of 14 yards.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28. And he throws right away. Almost intercepted.
That makes it second and 10.
Complete.
Cooper's the kind of impact player that every team in the country would love to have on their team. And we've seen some early film on him. Kirk and I, you know, we looked at it. He looks legit, but we'll see if it translates to real competition.
Under a minute left in the game. He heaves it to the end zone.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And if they don't convert here, then the game is over. And he hits him hard at the 17-yard line. That play could not have come at a better time.
Oh, that was absolutely the perfect time to go with that play on fourth down.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. The 10, the 5, a huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
It's first and goal, and they need a touchdown. They give to the tailback. Touchdown, and we've got a tie ball game. The play clock's at zero. They took too much time.
Offense.
Here's the extra point that can give them the lead. He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Tulsa's ranking, that doesn't mean anything right now.
Now, they've not played up to their expectations at all, but they have the football here late in the game. They're very fortunate to still have a chance to maybe win it because they've not looked like themselves.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Under a minute left.
throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
Pretty good effort here by the quarterback trying to squeeze that ball into a tight spot. Yeah, I know it was incomplete, but he didn't have too many other options.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Get to that quickly. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. Time football today. Low scoring defensive battle, and it's final. 14-13, Cowboys. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
Oklahoma State came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
Going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Street, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.